गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, सो वी विल बी सॉल्विंग सम प्रॉब्लम्स फ्रॉम एक्सरसाइज 9, चैप्टर 9, एंड द नेम ऑफ द चैप्टर इज डाटा हैंडलिंग. बिफोर वी स्टार्ट सॉल्विंग द एक्सरसाइज, आई विल टेल यू अबाउट द बेसिक्स व्हिच इज रिक्वायर्ड टू बी नोन. सो द नेम ऑफ द चैप्टर इज डाटा हैंडलिंग. व्हाट इज डाटा? Data means a set of classified information. A set of different information can also be a data, but they should be classified under several heads. Like example, your mark sheet. Example. Your mark sheet. It contains various classifications, isn't it? Like subject, marks, grade, name, age, you know. So there are various informations which are classified in various heads. Then any other example of data? Other examples of data could be your bank account, amount balance, amount debited, amount debited means taken out from your account, amount credited means how much amount is deposited in your account. Okay, these all are data. Also, when the teacher gives you a quiz kind of practice in the class, you know, quiz. During quiz happens, the scoreboard also shows data. Then scoreboard of various other games and sports. So whether whatever you become in your life, if you become a doctor, then you will need to handle, means use, various data. Like patients record, patients success ratio, how many patients were successfully treated, how many patients you killed, how many patients were alive by chance, okay, because of your medicine. All that data you have to keep. If you become a banker, then you will need to handle data of money, properties, etc. If you become a teacher, then you will need to handle data related to marks, exam, students' information, isn't it? So in every profession, data handling is required. So there are some mathematical tricks and techniques which is required to be learned at this stage for you all to understand what is data handling and how to do the basic data handling. Okay. Now we'll go to the exercise 9.1 and we'll try to solve this question. Now changing the screen. Let us read the first question. Question number. Question number 9.1 says, in a mathematics test, the following marks were obtained by 40 students. Arrange these marks in a table using tally mark. So see here, various marks are given. So what is the range of these marks? These marks, I do not see there is anyone who has got more than 9. So the range of marks are from 1 to 9 only. So for each student, we will be giving one tally mark. Now what is tally mark? Tally mark is like this. First of all, we'll write all the marks here from 1 to 9. Say 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9. Now, how many 1s are there? 1, 2, 2 only. So we'll give two lines like this. Now, two. How many twos are there in the first row? One, two is there. Second row, another two is there. Third row, another two is there. And fourth row, there is no two. So we'll give three lines like this. One, two, three. Now three, we will see. One, three. 2, 3, 3, 3, and no other 3. So we'll give 1, 2, 3. Now we'll see 4. 1, 4, 2, 4, 3, 4, 4, 4, 5, 4, 6, 4, and 7, 4. Now for 7, what we have to do is 1, 2, 3, 4, and fifth one is written like this, okay, 5 and then 6, 7. So a tally mark will always be a group of 5 vertical lines, okay. What are tally mark? tally marks are group of five vertical lines or their multiple. It should be, if it is one, only one will be there. If it is two, two will be there. If it is three, three will be there. If it is four, four will be there. But for five, we have to make it like this. So 10 will be 1, 2, 3, 4 and one more. So these two will be equal to 10. In this way, we have to write down tally mark for each of these. Five. How many fives are there? 1, 5, 2, 5, 3, 5, 4, 5, 5, 5, 6, 5. So 6, 5 will be written as 1, 2, 3, 4, one diagonal line and then one. 6 plus 5 plus 1, 6. Similarly, to find out how many 6 are there, 1, 6, 2, 6, 3, 6, 4, 6, 5, 6, 7, 6, 8, 6. So you can write 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and then 3 more. 1, 2, 3. Now for 7, how many 7s are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 are there. So we'll write 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. 8. How many 8s are there? 1. 2, 3, 4. 4, we'll write only 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 9, how many are there? 1, 2, 3, and no more. So 9 will be 3. Now the question is, how many students have obtained marks equal to or more than 7? Equal to or more than 7. So 7 is this. 5 here, 4 here, 9, and 3, so 12. How many students have obtained marks below 4? So below 4 is this, 3 plus 3, 6 plus 2, 8. So in this way, data handling helps us to analyze data. The data diya gaya hai, us data mein se समझने लायक इंफॉर्मेशन को निकालने के लिए बहुत सारे टूल्स होते हैं, ठीक है? इन टूल्स को यूज करना हम इस चैप्टर में सीखेंगे, जिसे हम कह रहे हैं डाटा हैंडलिंग। तो चूंकि आज इंट्रोडक्टरी लेसन था, इसलिए मैंने इस पर्टिकुलर क्वेश्चन को डिटेल में बताया। आप लोग क्वेश्चन नंबर 1 को अच्छे से समझ समझ के करिएगा, टेबल बना के, पेंसिल और स्केल से ड्रॉ करके। इन माई नेक्स्ट क्लास आई विल बी टेलिंग यू अबाउट द अदर वेज ऑफ handling data, that is in question number 2 and question number 3. Okay, it will be too much for one day for you all to understand, tally mark and practice it. Isko aap log apne class ko copy mein bana ke dekhiyega ek bar. Okay, thank you.